What was the most disastrous haircut ever? Yes. Some examples for you there.
I've got two answers and I get the screen going up there. One is my last haircut. No, or Samson's haircut. Samson's haircut.
No, Samson's haircut's a very good answer, actually.
That's me.
Yeah. Yes. You've just noticed.
Well, you must remember posing for these, or has this been...
I remember the one in the middle.
For the other two, I have no memory.
I know for a fact that in 1928, the New England Tool and Die Manufacturing Company was looking for a new screw that wouldn't slip out of the notch, and a man named Phillips worked for him, who had one of the most disastrous haircuts ever. It was parted in four.
That would be an example of a disastrous haircut that went good. This one, well, I mean, of course, there are many candidates, and Samson is one, but do you know anything about Louis VII of France? There he is on the left. We're talking about the 13th century. His queen became queen of a more famous king to us, being British.
Aquitaine.
She was Eleanor of Aquitaine, yeah, absolutely
long
right.
Hair, yes.
The point is, Louis VII was very religious, and the monks got to him, and he cut that hair off. He looks rather good there, but apparently he cut all his hair off, and she was furious at it.
Oh, right.
So cross that eventually she divorced him. I mean, there are other things too, probably, but the hair is mentioned by historians as one of the things...
He also cut his cock off. That...
maybe, I don't know, his mother may have sold her...
Your mother sold a mango?
Maybe. Maybe that had happened, yeah.
I divorce you.
But the consequences of the divorce were enormous, because she then went over, she was incredibly rich, she took her kingdoms with her, married Henry II, and it began the Hundred Years' War.
Yes.
So essentially it was the haircut that began the Hundred Years' War.
Yeah, but that's just something you say in polite company. Like when you tell the people you're breaking up with your partner, you go, yeah, well, I ain't like what he did with his hair, so I left. You can't really say about the king, he keep farting in bed. I just don't like his haircut.
Yeah. You're right. What is interesting about this poor king is he definitely wouldn't have had sexual relations with Eleanor's mother because he was very abstinent indeed, and he became ill, and the courtiers suggested it was because he hadn't had sex. Yeah. And so he consented to have the queen sent for, and they said, no, no, she's too far away. If you don't have sex immediately, you will die. But genuinely being told that he had to have sex or he would die, he actually said he would rather die chaste than live an adulterer.
See, that leads you to believe that he had a bad sexual experience as a child.
Yes.
Yes. And just, you know, because, you know, most men wouldn't rather, like, face death than have sex. So something happened when he was a kid, maybe a teenager, maybe his wee-wee got caught in the zipper, or mangled, or...
Yes, the mangled.
Or he said, I'm not ready for this yet, maybe just let me lick your elbow. And the woman just said, do what you do best. And
very good. The Simpsons make a reference to the Hundred Years' War.
Oh, dear.
Do you know what they call it?
Eh?
Operation Speedy Resolution. Anyway, so, we've all had bad hair days, but the one which helped start the Hundred Years' War takes some beating.